Let me tell you kind of what's going to happen over the next couple of hours. First of all, I'm going to call you down to the pavilion. We're going to.
He threw it from her waist down to her knees, and then he set her on fire. Had a child out of wedlock. All this stuff is just weighing me down. He doesn't want me. He wants somebody else. And I put that on, and I just started crying. I could feel something different. And he said, let's pray. And we prayed, and I said, are you sure he's going to forgive me for all my sins? He said, yes, every one of them. I said, okay, then, let's do it. And I prayed, and I prayed, and I prayed. And after that, I felt different. I just went home, and I threw away the beer, the doobies I had, everything that was in my house, I threw it away. And Steve came over, and I told him, if you want to be with me, you're going to have to go to church, too, because I can't do this by myself. But yeah. And so as they did that, I stood there watching the man in my dreams, the man I love, accept Jesus into his life. And then he's prayed, and then 6 months later, we got baptized. God just took a hold of my life, put me in a direction that I never thought I'd be on, because I lost my
mind. What?
Of Denver. We're having a great day. God has given us gorgeous weather to do some exceptional service work here. Thankful to City Connects because currently we're serving over 1,000 people per Sunday, the food out of this distribution. And then the other crazy stuff being moved behind us, believe it or not, we bought a haunted house and we're trying to figure out how to inventory it and use it for an evangelist outreach during Halloween, kind of a heaven or hell night to. We'll see. A thousand other little projects around here, but boy, here we go.
We're just excited to be here in Denver from Dallas. We were with Potter's House yesterday for a worship service and enjoyed that very much. We're blessed tremendously by it, and so we are blessed to be a blessing today. So we're excited to be a part of what God is doing here in Denver with Potter's House.
Wow, wonderful. God bless you all. We look forward to God doing some great work this week.
Three.
We love Potter's House.
Yeah, we need to start playing the. Do you have a speaker, Mr. Dixon?
I do.
Thank you, Drew.
All right, and we're back.
Just about.
We all pray like
a yellow submarine.
Woo!
Oh my gosh, why are you so wet? What is your name and why are you late?
Hi, my name's Pebbles.
Parsley, I'm senior pastor of Valley Ranch Baptist in the Dallas area, and I'm here with about 180 students and 40 adults in Denver. We're having a fabulous time. I make it a point to come every year with our students. First of all, it's a great way for me to get to know a lot of our new students and build relationships with them. We have outstanding adults that come with us, and I get to sort of shepherd them and pour into them while we're here. And I want to be wherever great mission stuff is happening in my church, and so I definitely want to be here. So it's a privilege to be here. So.
Los Niños Locos!
Yeah. Valley Ranch Baptist Church from Dallas, Texas, and we are here in Denver this week. Working with Pastor Mark, Westside Christian Fellowship, and all across the city with City Connects. We're really excited to be partnering with the different ministries and all that God's doing here in the city.
I'm excited with this group. John and his team have performed a phenomenal project for us. They've gone out and recruited students for our inner city school. They're cleaning the place, they're painting, they're doing what we asked them to do. They're showing the heart and the servant of Christ, and that's what we love about groups like John's. They love the Lord and they're willing to do what it takes to show that.
That's right. Back to back. Got your back.
Yeah.
A little dunking thing they had.
Right. Yeah, he forced me to get in the chair and get wet.
That was pretty exciting.
Getting to hang out with all the kids and just get to know them and love on them.
Full out World Cup game with all the kids.
Four square and be the queen bee.
Human foosball.
Was it Foursquare?
Maybe lunch, because I was hungry.
Flash tank. I got to see all the kids sing.
Meeting all the new kids.
I got to work in the library all day.
I worked in the library.
Valley Ranch has joined us this week for Z Camp 2014. I have to say, they have willing hearts. They're willing to do whatever they can. The kids are mature. They have jumped right in, hands on, any job, any kid. It's fantastic. They show up, they're setting the pace for our counselors. They're coming alongside the leaders and directors, and they have improved camp in a way. I can only think how incredible the church must be of Valley Ranch because of the way these kids and leaders have stepped in. It's phenomenal.
Really just like a blessing just to have these people here because I know that I would never volunteer to come watch all kinds of kids, but I think it's awesome, you know, like it's amazing what how God has put them in their place, you know.
They help to us and they help us with the kids.
To help, they make it, the job easier for us because it's us kids for us to look after.
Definitely the highlight of my day.
Give him a thumbs up, Juan.
Talking to Rob, who works here, and learning how God really changed his life and used him, and he really turned his life around in prison.
You're tickling?
My day.
Say hi.
You're the peace to the restless. You are.